In the wake of current events, ERWC News has team coverage on Emmanuel Goldstein's groundbreaking controversial new book. Our job is to report the truth, and if truth is what you want, you come to the right place. We set up an ERWC exclusive interview with author Emmanuel Goldstein. Let's go live to Dion and Daniel to get the truth.
I'm here live with Mr. Goldstein. Mr. Goldstein, Emmanuel, ongoing allegations against your book and multiple contradictory stories coming from the Ministry of Truth. In your book, you stated, and I quote, "The world of today is a bare, hungry, dilapidated place compared with the world that existed before 1914. In your words, can you tell us what that means?
Okay. Well, it's true. Before 1914, the world was thriving and had economic success. However, now it's a deteriorating, worn down, and barely livable place compared to the time before it. However, in the past, technologies were advancing rapidly, and it would have been easy to assume that it would continue to advance. However, the long period of wars and revolutions caused advancements to cease. The effects of nuclear war and the inefficient use of machines caused numerous negative side effects to arise."
Mr. Goldstein, is it true that you believe that an all-around increase of wealth of everyone around the globe will prove to be more destructive than actually beneficial?
In our society, it has improved lives of many around the globe. Everyone already has their basic needs met. Thus, inequality virtually doesn't exist. However, there aren't amenities. So imagining a society that was wealth distributed equally is logical to consider existing. Yet it is impossible to exist in the long term.
Oh. And why is that?
If you're looking for a new and beautiful place to live, well, welcome to Victory Mansions. It's the ideal place for families of all sizes. This gorgeous and nearly perfect house will stun you with its modern and dazzling interior finishes. This stunning two-story home is on a large lot in a hot neighborhood. Situated in a family-friendly neighborhood near a great park, this home is sure to go fast.
Well, during the 1920s through the 1940s, the economy of countless countries went on a steep decline. However, this weakened the militaries of said countries. During this period, countries were still figuring out how keep the industries producing resources but also preventing the resources from enriching people connected to its production.
So you believe that in order to stop people from getting rich, countries should go to war?
Well, the definition of war, put simply, is destruction. Staying constantly at war prevents an excess amount of resources to be produced and then sold. So the idea of the present war isn't necessarily to destroy lives, or rather destroy products produced from human labor, products intended to make life more comfortable, in the long run may make you more intelligent as well.
So tell us, are there any other alternatives than going to war?
Yes, there is seemingly many other better alternatives than going to war, such as by building temples and pyramids, but only with a war is a justifiable reason to waste resources according to the society as a whole. I mean, that's really the goal, to waste resources instead of letting them build up. War, simply put, gives you a different mindset than building a building could possibly give you, as war creates a bigger impact in our mind.
Okay, moving on, as we're running out of time, according to your book, do you truly believe that members of the inner party actually know the actual truth behind the war?
Well, I think we can use this with the use of doublethink It's used more by the inner party than, let's say, for example, the pros. This is because top officials have to understand that there is really no true purpose to engage in war. However, they have to make ourselves believe that there is a reason the war started in the first place. And the only people that actually know this, members of the inner party.
Question before we go. Mr. Goldstein, do you really believe the art of science really doesn't exist anymore?
It doesn't, or at least not to the aspect that we think. For example, in Newspeak, there is no official word for science. The concept of science almost completely ceases to exist. In the bottom line, new products are being discovered as the governments don't want things intended to improve the lives of the people. The only job of scientists now is to study humans, psychologists.
And that's all the time we have for now. ERWC will be back at 11. Thanks for watching ERWC News.
This is the Oceanic Alert System. The 2-minute skate will begin at the sound of the alarm.
Willy Pax. War Willy Plenty. Is. Peace. Willy Love. Freedom. Is. Slavery. Willy True. Ignorance. Is. Strength. Thought Police. Obey Big Brother. Worship Big Brother. Big Brother is always watching. Big Brother is watching. Thought crime does not entail death. Thought crime is death.
Thank you for your cooperation.